Hi, West Michigan. Tom Anderson here, and I am with a special guest today who is really hard to lasso. This is Carla Flanders, right?
Yes, that's right.
And what are we at?
We are at the Lakeshore Art Festival in downtown Muskegon.
The third annual with a new atmosphere, the new style, and the new director, and the new volunteers.
It's all the great new stuff mixed with all the amazing old stuff, so it's a really good combination.
So we actually have kind of like two shows out.
Yeah, we kind of do. We have our fine art category, which is up in Hackley Park, and then we have our general craft section, and actually we've added a whole block full of just children's activities, too. We have street performers, we have food areas, two different food areas, and lots of going on.
And I noticed one thing, connecting the two is all the food vendors.
I know, right? We have a ton of food vendors this year. We have over 20 places that you can choose to eat right here on location for your elephant ears and your corn dogs and all that yummy stuff. But then we also have stuff you can take home with our artisan food market. So prepackaged cookies and jams and spices and oils and all that good stuff.
Well, and actually, too, it extends so far east now that it actually goes to the farmer's market.
That's right. We encourage people to go to the farmer's market, do some shopping there, come on down Western and check us out, or vice versa. You could be here all day if you wanted to.
This is a whole bit of Muskegon area working together.
Because right.
I got to remind people, it's Muskegon area that's making this happen.
That's right. It's the entire Muskegon area. The entire county is making things happen. That's right.
Now, you're with the Lakeshore Chamber. Is that how your title is coming on this?
Yeah. I own my own business, CMF Marketing and Events.
Right.
And the Muskegon Lakeshore Chamber of Commerce has contracted me to run this event. And so I guess I'm technically the executive director for this event.
The buck stops there.
I know. Right, we'll just leave it there.
And look how happy she is.
I love it. I love this stuff. I mean, it's a gorgeous day. There's tons of people here. The exhibitors are happy. Guests are happy. And it's beautiful. I love it.
Have you talked to some of the exhibitors as to how they're doing financially?
We have. Yesterday, some of them broke their records. Unprecedented. We had our jury awards in the fine art category. And the gentleman that won first place said this is one of his best shows of the entire year. And he travels all over the country.
Oh my goodness, that's a complete turnaround from what we're used to in the past.
I know.
Things get old, they need change.
I know. Well, and we have a couple of vendors that are worried because they're selling out of stuff, and they're like, what are we going to do? We're selling out. So.
Well, I noticed that you're also helping because I had to drag you away from your family.
It's a secret.
Yeah. The boys, you're buying them something, and you were with the banker. No, you're the banker of the family.
Right. That's right. They had to come to me for money.
But you were just being a regular person walking around, spectator, looking what there is to buy and buying some great things for your kids, but watch out for those bow and arrows.
I know. Well, you know, I like to support the artists as much as anybody else, you know?
Okay, do you have any specials down here at all?
Well, we have a lot of special things happening, but yeah, we have these shirts that you have on. Muskegon, we have some of these for sale down here as well.
But this one is special.
That one's extra special.
North Muskegon. That's what happens when you're mayor.
Well, we also have ones that just say Watch Muskegon without that part on it, but they're both just as cool because we love it all. And then, you know, some of the little special nuggets I think that you could get from here is we just love that it's such a just an entertaining atmosphere. I don't know if you can hear the music in the background, but we have street performers performing in four different locations. And in the children lanes this year, we have a scavenger hunt where kids can come on down, get a little this paper, and they'll go to each station, get a different colored crayon, and color their own little masterpiece, and they get to take it home with them.
Well, I noticed too, we also have some live animals down there.
Yes, we do. If you have not seen this guy do these things, it's super cool. He has lots of different animals, and he does lots of tricks with his dog.
Okay.
And really cool tricks, and he gets the kids involved, and they get to milk a goat and do crazy stuff.
I just have to ask you, though, couldn't he have just said animals, assuming they'd be live?
Did I not? I don't know.
I'm going to ask him that.
All right.
You don't perform with dead animals. Well, that's why you put live animals there.
I will say, though, last year he has one of those goats that just kind of freezes up, you know, and falls over, and somebody's like, oh no, what happened to the goat? And he's fine. That's just what he does.
Okay, well, Kyla, we're going to let you catch up to your family. They're going to be spending more money than you have.
I know. I got to lasso them in.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. And a great job you're doing. And how many volunteers do we have helping us this year?
We have about 200 spaces for volunteers, and we can always use more. So if anybody, you know, wants to come on down tonight, come on down. We could use you.
Okay, but you know, we got a lot of volunteer shirts wearing the orange.
Yep.
The directors are wearing the green ones.
Correct.
And you have the walkie-talkie, so you can't escape.
That's right.
Okay.
You know, and they can show up right here at the Volunteer Hub, which is right
which
at
is
the Chamber of Commerce location.
Very good. Well, thank you very much. We'll let you get on your way. You're going to go on our way to see what we can do,
All right, do some shopping.
We'll do.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Here I am with a couple of Muskegon residents, and you are?
Karen Coburn.
And you are?
Katie Deems.
I recognize you. Oh, she works at the bicycle rack. Son of a gun, a new employee this year, my best female mechanic I've got. And what are you doing down here today?
Walking around with my daughter, letting her spend her paycheck on me.
Oh, that's a good way to go.
How
are you enjoying this today?
Oh, this is great. It's been great weather down here, and there's lots of great exhibits to look at. And
I see you've been to the farmer's market.
I did that, too, on my way.
Started that? Okay.
I walked through the fair and went down to the farmer's market, got my fresh tomatoes for our hamburgers later on.
Very good. How about you? You say you spent your whole paycheck already?
Almost.
You better come back to work next week then. Get another one.
Yeah, you can pay her more.
Wait a minute now. This is in cahoots here. But no, what do you think of the way it's set up? I mean, with the fine arts in Hackley Park and the craft and the other stuff down here with the food in between and the farmer's market, isn't it a fantastic thing for the city?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, it's set up really nice. I mean, I was able to see different shops when I don't usually get a chance to come down here to see. I've seen other shops downtown here.
Okay, but you're up front and close to them now. You take the time to be on foot to see them. So.
Correct.
Okay, well, we'll let you go. Continue spending money because that's what it's all about. And the more money she spends, the more she wants to work. So that'll work
exactly.
Fine.
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you very much, and we'll
Thank
see you,
you
Monday,
all
Katie.
Right.
Okay? West Michigan, see, even the locals are down here spending money. Here I am in a special tent here, and you are?
I'm Tacitus Billy Abani.
And where are you from?
From West Africa, Ghana.
Okay, what brings you to Michigan and Muskegon?
Yeah, you know, some people say love is crazy, but I say yeah, it's true. Because of love, I could come north to Muskegon.
This is the lovely woman that he chased and found in over here. And you're
That'd
from Michigan?
Me. Yep, I'm
and
from
you
Muskegon.
Are?
Jessica Bailey.
Okay, from what part of Michigan?
I'm from Muskegon.
Oh, from Muskegon?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Man, here I thought he came here just to sell these great goods just for
no,
the people of Muskegon.
We've been living here for about a year now.
A year now.
Okay.
Yeah. So these are my African culture and heritage. So there's something worthy back home that, you know, it's a very traditional thing for everybody to wear it. And beads, I gave you this. It's like they bring good energy spirits.
Good. Yeah. That's what I need.
And back home, though in English we call it bead, but we call it adiagba or chine.
Okay.
Or shika. And or Ashino.
How are we doing with the Muskegon people today? Are they?
Well,
are they...
They're doing good, pretty good. They really like the culture. They really like the movement. And the movement is all about, you know, peace and, you know, unity, you know, and bringing love to Muskegon, because love has carried me where I'm from. So since we are here, we're promoting the love and we're promoting Abeshin. When we talk about Abeshin, we say we are here.
Okay.
So since we are here in Michigan, Muskegon, we know we're still here and we're still, you know, doing movements and running things.
Okay, well, listen, we're holding up the crowd coming in here because you're the ones that are going to be taking the money and making the sales. And I tell you, it's a beautiful table to look at.
Thank you.
Really, really nice.
Thank
the
you.
Colors are just phenomenal.
Thank you.
It's bright even on a cloudy day.
Yeah, man. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
You're
I hope
welcome.
You do very well here and keep coming.
Yeah,
thank
bless.
You.
Thank you.
Here I am in a very unique booth that sells T-shirts that I just had to stop because look at this. They do cutouts, and this one just happens to be a bicycle. And you are?
My name is George, and my wife's Sawai.
Very good. And where are you from?
We are from Florida, from Zephyr Hills, Florida, near Tampa.
And you're enjoying the Michigan weather now?
I am so enjoying the Michigan weather. I'm telling you. The last show I did in Florida a week ago was 98 degrees. So this is just
Isn't this God's country?
It is God's country, for sure.
Well, and I noticed that you have basically have every design. How'd you come up with all of these?
Well, we start, like everything, you start out small, and then you add designs that sell to people, that speak to people. And so we started out with a few designs, and then saw what everybody liked and added designs that sort of matched.
Okay, because people requested different things.
Sure. And, you know, we started out with one musical instrument and then realized that they were popular at music shows. And so we added more and then some sports themes and that sort of thing. So,
Well, we're not stopping you from working. What are
oh,
you,
not at
you
all.
Have a little pair of scissors there, and you've got something white on the inside.
That's exactly right. All of our shirts are drawn first.
Okay.
And then they're layered fabric on the inside, and then we sew all around all of the details that we've drawn. And then we go back in, and we turn the shirt right side out, and we cut out the design. That's what our
okay, the lines
are
that you put on there, you cut that out,
they're
and
all
then
cut
the background is what shows.
That's exactly right.
Okay. Man, that's a double job.
It is a double job. Each shirt
a triple
is...
job. First, you got to do the outline. Then you got to sew the piece on the inside. And then you got to cut all the little thread ends off or something.
That's right.
And then you come out and cut out on the design lines.
Right. Each shirt is individually made, and try as we might, we don't we haven't come up with any shortcuts. So,
so you watch much television?
During certain parts of this
I was going to say, you don't dare take your eyes off when you're doing this.
Well, yeah. Some of it's easier than some procedures are easier than others.
So you're going to be cutting this little piece out right now, which is black.
Yep.
And underneath there you have red and white.
Right.
And you're cutting around your sewn area.
Right.
Oh, my goodness. So
and
that we can show a little piece right there on how it looks.
There we go.
That's a start.
That's
okay,
a start.
Okay, now you've still got to cut the inside of that heart out.
I'm going to cut this black piece out here.
Boy, if you got that to an art, I would have it not looking anything like
well,
that.
Well, I'll tell you what, the first ones don't look anything like you what you expect them to. And mistakes were made. Every once in a while, we make a wrong cut, and you know, that hurts at the end of the process here. But...
Well, those are sold as seconds then? Oh, okay. Oh, I'll be darned. Isn't that nice?
This one is not too difficult, but the order, this one takes more time.
Much more difficult.
Yeah.
More time. Those are the ones you do? He saves those just for you?
Yes, right.
Well, listen, we really appreciate you being here. This is really unique. I hope
you
do very well.
Thank you so very much.
Muskegon people are very happy with the variety that we have here. This is something nice to really show off.
Well, that's wonderful. Thank it's been you. Lovely to be here, and we look forward to coming back.
Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll be back.
The Health Hut, located at 3112 Henry Street in Norton Shores, offers a full line of natural and organic groceries, including fresh produce and free-range, hormone-free meats, eggs, cheese, and dairy, provided by local farms. Taking pride in carrying products which contain no preservatives, additives, or unhealthy fats, their wide selection of allergen-free foods can accommodate most specialty diets. From frozen desserts and entrees, to pastas, baking mixes, and cereals, to soups and salad dressings, to chips, candy, and other snacks. The Health Hut. We have your good health in mind.
Hi, I'm Brenda Sprader. Facing serious legal problems alone can be disappointing and stressful. When your freedom, your loved ones, or your finances are at stake, it is important to seek legal representation. I'm an experienced trial attorney and will work hard to protect what is important to you. I strive for equitable resolution and provide confidential guidance. I cannot promise specific results, but I do promise to be committed to zealously fighting to ensure that your rights are protected and that justice is served. If you would like to meet with me to discuss your legal issues, please call the number on your screen for a free consultation.
Sitting Pretty Pet Spa and Boutique is a full grooming salon with a wide range of services for dogs, cats, even birds, rabbits, guinea pigs, and ferrets. Their spa treatments include mud baths, facials, coat damage and repair, aromatherapy, de-shedding, teeth brushing, and paw repair and massage. Doesn't your best friend deserve a special spa day?
Dive!
Green board.
Emergency dive, 300 feet.
300 feet, aye, sir.
Sir, splash of water, depth charges.
All hands, battle stations.
Whether you're a first-time jewelry browser looking for an extraordinary engagement ring, a couple celebrating your 60th anniversary, or you're just looking to treat yourself or mark an important event, Rothheim & Swanson Gemworks is proud to offer custom-made selections handcrafted in America. Silver, fine-colored gems, diamonds, and gold jewelry, as well as strands of lustrous quality pearls. From ring and watch appraisals to in-house jewelry design and repair, ring sizing, remounting, to a complete rebuilding, you can rely on them to keep your old favorites looking new. K&S Gemworks, Muskegon's community jeweler. Memories made one at a time.
Hi, I'm Brenda Harris with Nexus Realty, turning dreams into an address. I support DSE TV.
Hi, here we are at something else, and this lady is holding a lot of plates, and you are...
Peggy Euler.
And where are you from, Peggy?
Muskegon.
Well, Muskegon, so you're a homegrown vendor here.
Yes, yes. I love it here.
Tell us about what you've got. You got these plates, but I can't put any food on them.
No, they're flowers. They're for your garden.
Oh, see? Okay. That's why you haven't stuck on the rods and stuff?
Yeah, it's a good way to use a lot of fancy old plates. And.
Where do you find these plates? These all look unique and kind of antique type.
Yes, a lot of them are antiques. We find them at estate sales,
okay,
or grad sales, or...
One person's junk is another person's treasure?
Goodwill, or...
Okay.
That kind of thing.
And
we
they
use
add
a lot
color.
Of depression glass.
Okay.
So,
and they add great color to anybody's garden.
They
That's
do.
The idea, right?
And they don't rust.
And they don't rust.
And you don't have to water them.
You're right. You're right. So if you missed coming down here this year, you have to come back next year, right? Because you're going to have more? If you have any left, if you find plates to make them with, right?
I think so, yeah.
How are you feel you're doing this year out down here?
We're doing fine. We're doing really fine.
Do you like the crowd? Or do you think it's a good crowd down here?
I do. I think it's a good crowd.
Well, and we've
nice.
Got everything down here. We've got the fine arts. We have this. We have the food between. We have the farmer's market. We just have a little bit of everything, don't we?
Yeah, it's awesome.
We have somebody coming over here, sneaking a couple things over here a minute. We're going to trade. Okay. I'll hang onto this one.
Just to
show you another one. You can hang onto that one over there. How's that?
Okay.
There. This is just an example of some more. See? These could be in your backyard. No watering. No wilting. No rusting.
No fertilizing.
No fertilizer. Okay. Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank
Appreciate you.
You
being down here, and I hope you're doing very well.
Thank you.
Making Muskegon happy and bright.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Here we are in front of the old Muskegon Bank building, which has got a lot of Muskegon treasures in it, the Love Muskegon shirts and everything else. And I'm standing here with?
Kendall.
And you are just brand new helping this little place doing this right now.
Yeah.
And what's the name of the company that's selling these?
Why Not Embroidery.
Why not?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, why not? That's
it.
Now, what do we have here? Something looks like something like I'm wearing, too.
Yeah, we have Watch Muskegon Go t-shirts. And
that's
then,
big and bold on that one, isn't it?
Yeah, and then right in the middle it says Watch Us Go.
Watch Us Go, M-U-S-K-E-G-O-N.
Yeah.
Very good. And then we have different styles here?
Yeah, and this one is for Muskegon County.
We're just getting started.
Mm-hmm. With the outline of Muskegon County with, like, the piers and everything like that on it.
Okay, and then these are like men's tees, and
men's
then you have
then
the V cut
and then
for the
youth.
Women's styles. Okay, mm-hmm. And how much did they sell for?
15 for small through XL, and then XL, 2XL is 17, and then 21 for triple
okay.
XL.
So anybody from Muskegon County that wants one of these now knows they can come and buy one from you, right?
Yeah.
You're new here, but you're going to be working here for a while.
Maybe. If they need help.
If they need help, okay. Appreciate it very much, but we wanted to tell people where they can get these shirts because these are popping up all over the place.
Yeah.
Appreciate it very much for your time. Thank
you. Thank you.
Here we are in front of t-shirts that I thought were just phenomenal. We had to show them off. And I am with?
Diane Nugent. We are with, this company is called Living Fresh out of Gaylord, Michigan.
Gaylord, Michigan. And
yes.
You seem to really be supporting Michigan.
We are. The company himself, he is a screen printer, and he really believes in supporting Michigan and doing something for the local economy.
And so, who's he?
The name is David Samolik, and he started out, he has a degree in graphic designing and a zoology degree.
Okay.
And when he was young, he was working in Washington state, and he ran into someone that was printing shirts, and he thought, I think I'd like to do that. So he started doing it out of his mother's oven several years ago, and his business has developed from that since.
Well, it's just absolutely amazing, the fresh coast and what there is of Michigan, and with the love and the Michigan State and the Michigan and
yes.
Great Lakes, Anchor Grower. I can't see them all, but we're going to get a shot of them later.
Okay.
But are these all his usually designs, or
yes.
Did you contribute to them too, or what?
No, David is the graphic designer, and he comes up with all the designs himself. His wife also came up with one of the designs, but Dave is responsible for
okay.
most of
you
them.
Got the old English script D.
Yes,
and then
do.
You've got the state of Michigan in the middle of it. That's really unique. And the bicycle, of course, I'm... Being in bicycles, I like that one too, but
yes.
You have the lower peninsula sitting on the seat and the upper peninsula tipped into the basket. So
yes.
It's just great, but I like the fresh coast because we have no sharks here.
That's right.
We have no salt water here.
That's right.
We have the best beaches in the world here.
That's right.
Glad you came over to West Michigan to enjoy them.
Well, it's been wonderful, and he's been very successful with his business due to West Michigan and to Michigan people, and he's very, very grateful for that.
Well, this is the second day of this show. You said you were doing rather well yesterday.
Oh, phenomenal. In fact, we've actually run out of merchandise. I mean, we've done so much. And we want to thank the people here in Muskegon for supporting him. And they do most of their business online. He does have a website.
Okay.
If they go to livinfresh.com, he has other things also
okay.
that they can see. So.
Well, that's great. He's going to get some shots of the shirts now, and
okay.
we're going to get out of your way because we have a lot of people that are being held up because of us. So. We're going to let you have some more sales.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very
much.
West Michigan, this is the place. Here I am in a kind of a different booth, and you are?
Missy.
Missy, and this is kind of an interpretive booth. It's
yep.
Hands-on for the people
mm-hmm.
that want to come along, right?
Yep, Arts and Crafts Studio. We do step-by-step paintings. You have an artist taking you step-by-step through whatever painting we're teaching at the moment. And
this is the one you just finished up
yep,
with on the class?
We just finished this one. We have the original, and then we kind of just do an interpretation of that. And it's basically, for any beginner painter, it's really easy, really fun. Everybody's always turns out really nice, too.
Better than paint by numbers.
It is better than paint by numbers because you get a real live artist.
Well, you know, one thing I noticed, too, though, when you were doing this, you weren't wearing glasses.
No, I know.
Now you got glasses on.
The sun was just blocking my view. So.
Okay, I thought maybe you could see better with them on or better with them off.
Definitely with them on.
But with them off, everybody's artwork looks great, right?
Of course.
And most of these people are first-timers, probably.
Mm-hmm.
Look, they're so intense on this.
Yeah, that's usually what we, our specialty is people who haven't touched a paintbrush since they were in junior high or elementary school. And we just like to get art out there to people who haven't really experienced it in a while.
Well, we tell them, though, that artwork doesn't become valuable until they pass away, right?
Until they're dead, according to you and most history books, yes.
Okay. Now they're all going to sign these, too, and they're going to
mm-hmm.
be the family heritage items,
masterpieces.
Right? Masterpieces in the family.
Yep.
And you've been having a good turnout for classes?
Yeah, we have been. Earlier we did kind of like an open paint where people just kind of came and we taught them all a little bit individually. And now since it's getting busier, we have scheduled paintings on the hour.
Okay, and then you get the little canvases that they paint
yeah.
on and you come up with a concept for them and
yep.
you walk them stepping through it.
Oh, yeah. That's how we do it.
Very good. And this time it happened to be the lighthouse over the sunset
yep.
with fireworks in the background.
One.
Excellent.
It's very festive. So.
Now, how long have you been doing something like that, Missy?
I started working when we opened, so it's been about a year and a half. Yep, we're out of Ada, Grand Rapids area. So
very good.
Have a studio out there and everything.
But right now, remember, you're on the West Coast.
We're on the West Coast right
God's
now.
Country. That's what the scene is
we
all
love
about.
It here.
Overlooking
obviously,
the lake.
We have a lot of our paintings are inspired by this area, so.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank
Enjoy
you.
What you're doing, and I tell you what, you got 2, 4, 6. Man, you got 12 people here working.
Yeah, we got a lot.
Oh, that's super. That's super. Well, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you.
You're doing a great job. Here we are at a special booth. It's actually the exhibitor check-in, but it's kind of the headquarters for the Lakeshore Art Festival. And you can see you have shirts here available for those to buy to wear around the year around here advertising this. And, of course, we have the Watch Us Go stickers and the Watch Us Go buttons. But these are all available, be worn proudly. The tie-dye, just fantastic. Lakeshore Art Festival. And of course, go down here we have a couple of volunteers wearing the volunteer shirts, these bright orange ones, and they stand out. They are all over the place. These are part of these 200 people that are volunteering to help make this happen. Appreciate what you're doing today.
Thank you.
Thank you. And you are?
Shirley Franklin.
Shirley, appreciate helping Muskegon.
Thank you so much. Anything to make this a success, and it's going quite well.
And you're handing out maps because it's so spread out and so many things to do, you have to give people directions. Okay. Thank you very much, Shirley.
Beginning as a lumber company in 1911, Frederick's Construction has been servicing the Muskegon area since 1969. Family owned and operated, they specialize in roofing, siding, windows, insulation, additions, doors, decks, and more. Located at 1940 Commerce Street in beautiful downtown Muskegon, their phone number is 231-722-3937. When you want quality workmanship, you want Frederick's Construction.
The Village at Park Terrace Senior Living Community, offering beautiful yet affordable one and two bedroom apartment homes as well as two bedroom cottages. Rent includes a wide variety of exceptional services, from daily meals shared in the dining room or delivered to your door, to scheduled activities and social events, to 24-hour emergency on-call service. Their expert caring staff is there to assist you with all of your retirement needs. The Village at Park Terrace Senior Living Community, where you can enjoy the luxuries and comfort of your own home without the work and worry.
At Ramos Towing, we know your time is valuable. That's why we always provide you with a fast response and efficient service. Whether you need gasoline, a jump start, lockout assistance, a tire change, or a tow, you can count on Ramos to get the job done. Our variety of flatbed and heavy-duty trucks can handle any type of tow. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, it's Ramos to the rescue.
McDonald's Candies, 1064 South Getty Street in Muskegon, features an assortment of chocolate-covered nuts and creams, peanut clusters, fudge, seafoam, turtles, cherry cordials, and regular and holiday novelties.
At Bowman's Body Shop, we're proud to say you're driving home our reputation. Our team of highly skilled professionals uses the latest high-tech equipment to diagnose the extent of the damage to your vehicle. Bowman's Body Shop, 2846 Getty Street in Muskegon.
Here I am with somebody working all by themselves out here in some artwork, and you are?
Haley.
Haley, what got you into doing this? Do you volunteer or pay for it? Or?
No, I'm just, you know, coloring for fun, I guess.
Coloring for fun, okay. Yeah. And this is interpretive art by everybody that walks along?
Yeah.
And you're just adding your artwork over everybody else's?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I get a kick out of your apron, though. Keeps you covered all the way down your ankles.
Yeah, it's a little big.
Have you been a little messy at all? Or?
No, that I decided to wear the apron, you know, to keep the paint away. And
okay, what's some of your artwork up here?
Mine's the teal.
Oh, so, yours is the, okay, you
yeah,
do
I
you
did
do
my
just
name.
The color, okay.
Yeah, I did my name and I did my grandma's name. And I wanted to embarrass my boyfriend and put his name and then put his hat on there. So I figured that would be funny.
And you're putting your teal around other artworks too?
Yeah. So
and you're just having a great time. You're leaving your mark on Muskegon, right?
Yeah.
Are you from Muskegon area?
I am.
Very good. And you're having fun down here?
Mm-hmm.
Great. It looks like you're all smiles. Yeah. And you haven't wrecked anybody else's artwork yet?
Nope.
Okay. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah,
keep going.
Yeah, thanks.
Hi, West Michigan. Back again. And this time I found a very unique type of craft. And you are?
John Timmer.
And where are you from, John?
I'm from Jenison, Michigan.
Okay, and what do we have here besides empty barrels?
We have a lot of furniture built out of recycled, reclaimed barrels that have all had bourbon in them. And at some time, some of them have cider or some kind of beer, barrel aging.
I bet you found volunteers to empty them for you.
I have, yeah. That's not hard to get. And I probably have the best smelling workshop in West Michigan.
Where do you get these barrels from, then?
I get them from different brewers that are, you know, when they get them from the distilleries, they'll age a couple lines of beer in them. And then when they're done with them, that's when I come in.
Okay, so they are available, but I've never seen anything like this, and you turn them into unique furniture.
Yeah, yeah.
Your idea? Or?
Yeah, this was all my design, my workmanship. I didn't have a clue how to weld, and now I weld every day. I bought a welder and just started going to town, self-taught.
It's fun, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fun.
You step back with a sense of accomplishment?
Yeah, yeah. Every piece is different from the next one, and... they all have their own little characteristics, you know.
Well, then you've taken stays out for some of these, and you use them for cross members.
Yeah.
You've got them on a lot of other devices here, too.
Yeah.
Tell us about some of these other things that you have made with them.
Well, the West Michigan area is such a big beer community.
Really?
Somewhat, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. And so what I've done is I had so many growlers under my kitchen sink, and I've figured out a way to display those, and I thought... the bourbon barrel staves and steel, you know, make a nice display for the growlers.
And then you've got some on the far end are actually bottle openers too.
Yeah,
you're taking a piece of a stay and.
Yeah, I try to use all my scrap wood.
So they have no scrap.
Well, I don't really have a lot of scrap because if I have some really small scrap, I'll throw it on my grill.
And there you go. Beer flavored cooking.
Beer, yeah,
bourbon.
Bourbon, yeah, it's wonderful to cook chicken or burgers or things like that.
You're not wasting a thing then, are
you? No, not really. No.
Now, the chairs where you're sitting on, mm-hmm. basically the regular chair, then you've taken a piece of wood just kind of match the barrel wood, right?
Yep.
So, yeah. But it's a good little place to sit around and have a glass of bourbon or
Absolutely.
A glass of beer.
That's what I think, yeah. Yeah, I put an exterior finish on these too, so they can be on the outdoors patio or inside.
I was going to say, it looks like they're in a man cave or otherwise outside on a patio deck, okay?
Yeah, it can go pretty much anywhere. We have one of these in our kitchen.
Oh, very good. Well, yeah, better than buying one.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, and how's it been going here for you?
It's been going good. Good.
Very good. Yep. Well, we're happy you're here in Muskegon providing something unique and different again, because that's what makes our little town special.
Yeah, so. It's a lot of fun.
Enjoy, and thank you for being here, and... Hope you sell a lot, and the boss, you wouldn't get on camera, but we'll just talk about her.
There you go.
And
Absolutely.
Who is she?
That's my wife, Teresa.
Okay, and she's really the boss. She's the one that keeps the whip behind you.
Yeah, she's always kept me in check. Yeah.
Okay.
28 years.
Now you can tell her she didn't go on camera. We talked about her.
That's right.
Okay. Thank you very
Thank
much.
You.
Great having you here at the Art Festival this year.
Thank you.
Here we are standing next to a sponsor's sign, but we're also standing at the entrance to Hackley Park, and this is where all our fine arts are. We've been covering about 4, 5, 6 blocks, it seems like a mile, lined on both sides with an awful lot of activity, crafts, and things of nature that are just really fun to be with. And most of them said they've been selling a lot of merchandise out, but here is the fine art. We're going to go in and check it out here and make sure that our sponsors are recognized that help make this happen and keep the cost down for you, our public, coming out here. Here we're at a little booth in the fine arts in Hackley Park, and you are?
Mike Miller.
And Mike, where are you from?
We're from Saline, Michigan.
Very good. First time over here, or you've been here before?
This is our third year doing this arts festival.
Okay, so this is the new one, the new atmosphere,
right.
New image. Okay,
that's
right. How are we doing over here?
We're doing good. You know, they've had good traffic. They have a bunch of really good artists out here this year. Weather's great. Couldn't
well, we ordered that
better.
For you.
Yeah, you should.
But you know what caught my eye was the beauty and the brightness you have of these. These are flowers you don't have to prune. You don't have to fertilize. You don't have
water.
To weed.
Yeah,
you don't have to water.
Exactly.
And what's their intention? Is it in the garden or in bowls? Or?
More decorative for indoors.
Okay.
We do have a lot of people that ask us about putting them outside. We recommend spraying them with the polyurethane
to protect them from the weather. Okay.
Yep. My wife is the one that does the painting. My dad and I do the cutting. It's all basswood that we work with.
Okay. Okay. So it's a very light wood then.
Yep. It sure is. We've been at our craft now for about 17 years.
Oh, my goodness. You should have everyone down doing art.
Yeah, exactly.
And... are they really popular with the people walking around? I mean, the colors just catch your eye.
Yeah,
make
they
you
sure
stop.
Do. Yeah, I would say our tulips that we have out in the very front are our most popular flowers that we cut out. Obviously, being in Michigan with Holland in the area, and tulips being a big hit, it's our best seller.
Well, you've got a lot of work on those things too. It looks like
yeah, we do.
The top petals.
Yeah,
type.
A lot of the petals we're cutting, we're using a lathe to create the shape or a scroll saw. There's quite a few that my dad and I will cut flat and soap to get the petals to curl, to kind of give the perception of a real life flower.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so you actually soften the wood up and curl it when they're soaked. Okay.
That's right.
All right. Okay. Knowing me, I'd probably break them in the process. Okay, Mike, we just got some items in there in the back that are drying, and these are freshly painted?
That's right. My wife and my daughter, Nina Miller, who's 11 years old, worked on these yesterday afternoon and evening. Nina did quite a few of the, I'll pull one out here. She did quite a few of the dots. This is done actually with a toothpick. You dip it in the paint.
Oh, my goodness.
And then you dot it to create the sunflower.
But this is fun, isn't it, for you too?
Yes, it is.
And you're down here helping Dad making all this money? Get you out of the house, doesn't it?
That's right.
Oh, those are nice.
Gets the creative genes flowing. So.
When you paint these things, how long does it take to dry? Because I'm sure that basswood kind of soaks in.
It does, yeah. So they finished these up yesterday probably about 6:30 in the evening. They dried all overnight. What we have to do, when my daughter and I came in this morning, is we needed to put a wax coating over the flower to protect that paint. So right now that's what's been drying in the sun in the back. So once that dries, we take them home, put it through a buffer to give it a little more of a semi-gloss appearance and color.
But it's just neat. You're using a buck of sand just to hold them in and then sitting out in the sun.
Yep.
Nature's way of drying them.
That's it.
Oh, and sunflower in the sun.
Yeah,
okay.
That's right.
Well, I appreciate it very much. And
thank you.
Hope you do well. I tell you what, this is the most colorful booth there is around here, Mike.
Thank you so much.
You did a good job, and you do a good job, too.
Thank you.
Here I am with a guy that's been hard to break in on because he's been selling so many of his products, and these are absolutely fantastic hats. Australian hats, right?
They're Australian patterns. I brought the patterns over with me from Australia. We worked in Australia to learn how to make them. My material is shipped by my brother-in-law from Australia.
Okay.
This weave is a Australian weave. Blocks 90% of the UV rays. It'll get burnt to the bloody ass.
Now, basically, you just get the material, and then you actually produce these hats.
Yes, sir. We hand make them.
And you're the only one that sells the leather, right?
Yes. The folks in Muskegon are very, very loyal, very nice people. They actually, I get online email address because I put my phone number inside the hat and my email.
Well, but I thought that was you're back from the pretty ladies, but your wife doesn't know about it?
Oh, crikey. My wife is one of the most wonderful person in the world.
Oh, that's great. And she's taking care of your dog right now.
She's taking care of me and my dog.
Well, what inspired you to be doing this? You said you were in Australia.
It's a bloody long story. I used to be an engineer, a contract engineer for Eaton Corporation. My contract ran out, and my wife's sister was married an Australian.
Okay.
In Australia. So I got this big hunk of cash from my contract. And I said, honey, you want to go to Australia to see your sister's wedding? And it was like, oh my gosh, yes. Very close sisters. We went to Australia for the wedding. And we were there for like extra, and I ran into this gentleman who's owned a hat company, and I said, look, show me how to make the hats. He said, no, you're going to have to do a two-year apprenticeship. So I said, okay.
Okay.
Now remember, I'm a mechanical engineer. Now I'm an apprentice. But it was great. We learned, we had fun, we lived on Byron Bay. And we swam, we fished, we went all across the country in Australia, and we got the hankering to come home. So we came home. I wholesaled for a long time, and then it didn't please me. So we started doing rodeos, horse shows.
Okay, where the hats would be more popular as leather hats. Yeah.
We would go with the 1 year we got walk-in, and we're doing Australian hats. Next year, it's commercial. Everybody's got Australian hats. So we decided to do craft shows because the folks appreciate a craft. This is a craft. It's an art. It's a craft. But everybody wants to sell me it's an art. I love it.
You're having fun doing it. That's what counts.
Yes, sir.
So how many years have you been making these hats? You said you've been coming here to Muskegon 18 years.
I'm 28.
28 years been making these hats.
Yes.
And I noticed one thing, you have a little bit of Australian brogue, too.
We lived there for 2.5 years, and I never lost a bloody thing.
Even the colloquialism, you're doing well.
Well, you know, there's a thing about the Australians and the Kiwis, the New Zealanders.
What's that?
It's like the North and the South, a kind of a... But
okay.
Their thing is, who had the worst criminals?
Right.
Sent from England.
Right, because so that's how England got rid of the criminals.
The Australians claim that they were worse than the New Zealanders. And it's kind of neat. It's nothing.
It becomes a joke, more
nice,
or less.
Yes, yeah. It's nice.
You can't change the past, and they developed upon it and became very
and
great.
What they do is they make a good, like,
lightness
joke
out
of it.
Yeah.
If you go into a pub, it's very, very congenial. And you'll holler back and forth. It's sort of like the North and the South. Oh, we had this and you had that. But it's nice.
Now, wait a minute. You've been doing this for 18 years, coming here, making hats for 28 years. That means you must be over 60. How old are you?
80.
80? Is that all?
March
12th. You've
got
a good many years.
March 12th, 1935.
Ah, super. You know?
How's
you
that,
should
mate?
Be very dang proud of it, because not everybody gets to be as healthy as you.
I got
to
tell you something. My wife feeds me my vitamins and makes sure I eat well. I
she
don't
keep
I,
you around, doesn't she?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Cuts my cholesterol down. That's white bread. You can't eat that. I love white bread.
Okay. Well, listen, we'll let you go because
thank
people
you
are walking
very much.
By. But
it's
I seen you sell a couple
nice...
hats while we're just waiting to talk to you. So keep up the
you.
Good work and keep the top on Muskegon.
Oh, I got to tell you something. I love Muskegon. Honest to God. Folks order on by mail or whatever, you know, and it's really nice.
It's just nice that you come here and that smiles everybody's faces with the product
thank
you have.
Thank you,
sir.
City Glass and Mirror features glass for every purpose, servicing both residential and commercial. Their full-service showroom displays every aspect of what City Glass has to offer. Handrails, closet systems, replacement windows, bath hardware, shower doors, and custom mirrors. They even offer auto glass and storefronts to see all they have to offer. City Glass and Mirror, located at 100 West 7th Street in Grand Haven and 631 Commerce Court, Suite 10 in Holland.
In the 150 years we've been in business, many things have changed. Our greatest achievements are rooted in the things that haven't. Years ago, the person you called banker was also the person you called friend. When it came to service, there were fewer layers and friendlier smiles. And banks earned the trust of their customers and community while working tirelessly not to lose it. At Independent Bank, all this remains true today. Sure, we've made advances that help customers bank more conveniently and more comfortably. But at the end of the day, we know that people really need a trustworthy partner committed to their financial goals, dreams, and aspirations. And we've been happy to be that partner since 1864.
Hello, Muskegon. My name is Mark Dubin. I'm the owner here at RPM Automotive. We've been here since 1996. We're a full-service auto repair center. We do both foreign and domestic repairs. Most of our repairs are performed same day. We do everything from AC, engine repair, and computer diagnostics. Feel free to call or come by and see us. We're located on Getty Street next to the Getty Street Grill.
Muskegon Area District Library, formerly the Muskegon County Library for the Blind and Physically Handicapped, offering public library books and magazines, both fiction and nonfiction, to visually and physically impaired individuals. With their new location at 4845 Airline Road, they can be contacted at 231-737-6310.
With four convenient locations, Jack's Corner Store is one-stop shopping at its best. Tools, fresh meats, produce, chips, snacks, and other grocery items, beer, wine, and liquor, even gas and lottery. That's why Jack's is your corner store and so much more.
Another booth, another artist, and you are?
Skeeter Ashinger.
And from where?
From Aurora, Illinois, and we're actually Florida residents, but we come up in the summer and live in Aurora.
God's country.
God's country. That's our native state.
Okay, and what do you have that, I have a tough time explaining this. You can explain this.
Well, I started out with the miniature face sculptures, and I did them in shadow boxes.
Okay.
And enhanced the faces fashion-wise or whatever materials I decided. And we both like collecting things. So I had been collecting various pieces of wood. Being that we're in Florida, a lot of the seed pods that we use for the base core product of my pieces.
Okay.
But I didn't know how I was going to really use them. And then, you know, you're laying awake at night and you can't sleep. So it's that aha moment, and you go, well, that would make a good base body for the faces. So the faces came out of the shadow boxes and onto my pods. And then I also have cypress knee, and we walk the paths in the pasture, and you get weathered wood. We have grapevine root that we sandblast. So it's a variety of woods in the end that I put together. Then I add the resin clay faces, which are actually sculpted first to give them their individual character. And then I use the arms, that's resin clay, and whatever other enhancements that I need to use for the body itself. I use sculpted leather. I use metals. Metalsmithing is sort of my sidekick in making jewelry, so
okay.
A lot of times I incorporate metal into the pieces as well. So in the end, I end up with a elongated, figurative type of sculpture piece.
Which is absolutely beautiful wall artwork.
Thank you. Yes, because the walls, some of them are just branches and bark put together with the face. Always have the face in it. And my last little thing I do with my pieces is put a little bird as my signature touch. Touch of nature, Mother Nature.
Okay, but most of your product then is found in nature in Florida.
Yes. Well, yes and no, because the weathered wood I get up in Illinois.
Oh, okay. Okay,
yes.
From the pastures. Okay.
Right, exactly.
All right.
So,
but
and,
I know the grapefruit roots are down.
Well, it's down there and up in some of the the areas like out west.
Oh,
that
okay.
Sort of thing too.
So, okay.
Yeah,
so
wherever
you have fun.
We go to the sawmills. And get in cuts from the lumber that they cut, they save for the artist. And so we rummage through it, purchase so much a pound.
And but you see something in that raw product that nobody else
sees. Exactly. You go through a pile of wood to see what there is to be had.
Oh, super.
But keep your eyes open all the time.
Because
even though you're scouting around and visiting or traveling or something like that, my husband's even stopped the car because he saw something along the side of the road. So it's always keeping your being aware.
And this is your second year here, Ms. Gilman?
Yes, it is.
And
yes,
how are you doing up here?
Very well.
We've heard nothing but positive comments.
Good.
Because
good.
This art festival basically has been rejuvenated about 3 years ago.
Okay.
And it's all new, and you got in a new factor, and everybody seems to be just overwhelmingly happy
the
with the way it is.
The weather is fantastic
well,
this weekend.
This weather is like this all the time up here.
Oh, yeah, right. That's the reason why we go to Florida in the winter.
Okay. Well, appreciate you being here
very much.
Thank you, and I hope you do very well.
Thank you.
It's really, really... It'd break up any wall and really add.
That's a good conversation piece.
Oh yes.
Yes.
So thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Here I am in another booth in the Fine Arts in Hackley Park, and you are?
I'm Gordy Anderson.
Gordy Anderson, that's not a bad last name. I'm Tom Anderson.
Well, nice to meet you, Tom.
What is your artwork in here?
I do copper and brass sculptures. I cut everything out with a torch and tin snips and mold it by hand and braze it all together.
Well, you use an expensive material with the price of copper nowadays.
Yeah, well, copper, well, it goes up and down, right? Yeah.
Okay, and what inspired you to do this, Gary?
Be honest with you, it was one of my first jobs out of high school. I worked for a man that did this stuff, and I started cutting leaves for him, and I learned the trade from him, believe it or not.
You never wanted to give it up?
No, been doing it on and off for years, but the last 5 years I've been doing it pretty steady.
Oh, it gets you to travel around to art fairs like this, right?
Absolutely. I get to see the great state of Michigan. It's awesome.
Where are you from?
I'm from Livonia.
Okay.
But I live in Whitmore Lake right now.
Okay, okay. Yeah. The other side of the state.
Yeah, near Ann Arbor.
Yeah. Now you're over in God's country today. Isn't this a beautiful breeze we have?
Oh, my God, it's beautiful over
here.
We
ordered this weather just special for you.
Thank you.
And basically, there's our wall hangings.
Yep.
And not only are they artistic, like the boats and the leaves and the Michigan, but you also have the Red Wings logo, the Detroit logo, the Spartans logo.
I tried the Michigan theme here going, right? Everything's Detroit, Michigan. So.
And then your color differences is your copper and your brass.
Copper and brass. And I heat the copper to get different colors with it, you know.
Okay. So actually you burn the color in.
I burn the colors in.
Okay.
Paint with a torch.
Paint with a torch. And then you clear them with...
Then I put a clear gloss on it. It seals them. Yep.
Okay, it seals them up. So.
Yeah.
But they're beautiful wall hangings, and they'd be so decorative in anybody's home somewhere.
Well, thank you. Yes, they
break up a bare wall, and some of these look like you have quite a bit of time and hours in them.
Quite a bit. This bridge right here, as a matter of fact, took me like 3 days, so 25 hours to make that bridge.
Would have taken me 3 years. And it wouldn't look like that.
Yeah. Well, the first one didn't take that. It took a little longer. But.
Well, that's fantastic. That's beautiful. Well, I appreciate you being here. Are you doing well here in Muskegon?
Yes, I love it here. It's been a great show.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for your time. We'll let you get back to work.
All right, nice. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Here I am with a artwork that has been very attractive to a lot of the young kids. And you are?
Jim Cook.
And where are you from, Jim?
I'm from Fremont.
Fremont. Oh, mm-hmm. That's a great community.
It is indeed.
And this is the boss over here?
That's top management.
And you are?
Joe Cook.
And you live with him?
I do. 48 years worth.
48 years. Yeah. Excellent. And what do we call this? It's beautiful. I love the look of copper and those balls in there and glistening.
The one that's running, we call that the split up. I don't recall why we call it that, but that's what
Who
we call
cares,
it.
Right?
Exactly. As long as people are buying them, we don't care.
Well, how do you make it to revolve? I mean, you have a little revolving area in there, then the water comes out at an angle?
No, actually, there are two holes on either side of the circle, and as the water is forced up into the larger diameter, it's forced out those smaller holes, and that causes it to rotate. So the more pressure you apply through the faucet, then the faster it'll rotate, and the further it'll throw the water. And in this case, it'll go out probably in the 35 or 40-foot diameter range.
Shall we try it?
No.
We can't get the camera wet and all these people would go running.
We hear the neighbors packing heat, so we don't want to.
Yeah, but so, life has got to be fun.
Yeah.
So not only is it a sprinkler, it's a really relaxing thing to watch in the backyard.
It is indeed. It is indeed. Yeah, we go through several hundred of these a year or a season, actually, and we find people really like it. So
how are we doing here in Muskegon?
Pretty well. Pretty well. Today's a little slow, but yesterday was a great day. And so
we heard yesterday was a swamping day for everybody out here.
Yeah, it was very nice. We were certainly looking forward to coming back down here.
How many years have you been coming here?
Well, this is only our second here, but I've been making the sprinklers for, this is my 16th year.
Okay.
Yeah, I used to do it part-time when I worked full-time for a local company here in Muskegon, as a matter of fact, and retired about 7 years ago. And
So this is your regular route from Fremont to Muskegon?
Well, yeah.
Pretty good. You didn't want to give it up.
No, I didn't, but I enjoy doing what I do. So.
Okay, and it's called Copper Time Sprinklers.
That's what we're called.
Uh-huh. I read it. That's how I knew it. It's right there. Made in Fremont, Michigan.
CopperTimeSprinklers.com.
Michigan-made product.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Very good.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Hope you have a great time.
Yeah, thank you.
And don't get lost on the way home.
I won't.
Okay. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
West Michigan, here we are wrapping up one fantastic day on a Saturday. It's 4th of July, of course, or 2015, and this is the second day of the Art Festival downtown. Every vendor we talked to has just been having a great time. And, of course, this is the third annual with the new people in charge and the new concept and the food and everything else, the fine, the craft. Glad you could join us. Hope you could come down here next year. Everybody we talked to is just absolutely proud of this. And as you can see, we're in front of this Old Toff stage here in downtown Muskegon. If you don't come out here once in a while, you're really missing a lot. Tom Anderson saying thank you for watching.
The Butterburger is made of just three cuts of fresh Midwest beef. Nothing more, nothing less. It reminds me of the good old days when we first opened Culver's. We would call up the butcher shop and we'd buy our beef from there each and every day.
You can't get any fresher than that.
Well, today we still get fresh beef into our restaurants. We don't skimp on the quality of our beef. So we got the sirloin, the chuck, and the plate. No fillers, that's it.
All prized cuts. All well marbled for richness and flavor. And you put those all together, that ends up to be a very high quality burger.
This is where those three wonderful cuts of beef come together.
You can just tell that blend is working in there.
And we sear them, and that seals in the juices of the burger. And that's where that wonderful steak taste comes from.
It doesn't get any better than that.
You know, all our burgers are cooked to order, but that's a little different than most of our competitors. The Culver's Butter Burger.
Craig, that is one great burger.
Welcome to Delicious.
I believe that the true value of a funeral is the gathering together of people and the sharing of stories. Stories of love and honor, respect and memories. We gather together because we as human beings, we need that contact, that emotional connection that we get when we gather together. We gather together at all sorts of times, at birthdays and anniversaries, at graduations, retirements, weddings, and at funerals. And at each and every one of those gatherings, we tell stories. And it's through those stories that we show our love and respect. It's through those stories that we learn and grow. And it's through those stories that we heal. Gather together, share the stories, celebrate a life, heal the heart.
Established in 1973 by Paul M. Lattice, Lattice & Hoops Law Offices has been a multi-service law firm specializing in accident cases, personal injury, wrongful death, Social Security disability, divorce, probate and wills, and real estate. When it comes to choosing the right attorney for your legal needs, don't choose out of town, choose local legal counsel. It really pays. It's experience when it counts. It's Lattice & Hoops Law Offices.
ASAP Auto Sales, located at 2486 South Getty Street in Muskegon, offers a wide selection of reasonably priced used vehicles from cars and trucks to vans, SUVs, and four-wheel drives. With new selections coming in every day, ASAP's lot is always full, which means whenever you drop in, there's about 100 vehicles to choose from. With a wide selection of vehicles, both domestic and import, they have it all. ASAP Auto Sales, 231-830-9000.